My name is Terry Rogers. My wife Karen and I have been members in this church for quite a long time, and we've been participant in various ways in the music program during that period of time. One of the impediments to that program has been, for many years, an organ that was, let's say, not up to speed. 7 years ago, we had the good fortune to hire a new music director. And this music director immediately recognized that there was an opportunity to improve the organ situation. And with her energy and foresight and organizing capability, we have what you see before you now, Ortloff Organ Company, Opus Number 2. Number 1 is in upstate New York. Number 3, Opus Number 3, will actually be dedicated with concerts in 2 weeks from now in Cape Elizabeth, Maine. And I'm happy to say that one of my oldest and dearest childhood friends lives there and will be attending those concerts. Fast forward to today, our soloist is none other than that same music director, Susanna Valo. You can read her bio in the handouts that you have, so I won't repeat it. Suffice it to say that she has fingers in many aspects of the music scene in Seattle, as a teacher, as a performer, as a leader, as a director, and we are very fortunate to have her here as our music director. So without further delay, let me introduce Susanna Valo. Would you give her a warm St. Dunstan's welcome?
Thank you. Thank you. Wow, what a pleasure it is to play for you. Thank you for coming on one of the first beautiful weekends we have. It is a joy for me to play for you. I feel like I have a home turf advantage because I work here and now I get to give a recital here. Yes, it is a joy to play this instrument. We're so proud of it and so happy to have it here. When I was crafting my program, what I wanted to play for you, I had a couple goals. The first was to show off as many of the colors of the organ as possible. And you already heard many with just that one song. It's quite the journey. And another was to play music by composers that don't often get played. Women, African-American composers, and then some themes kind of came through. So we have preludes and fugues for the first three songs. But they're very different from each other. So the next two pieces will be preludes and fugues. The next one by a blind organist, Josephine Boulay. Some of you will know the name Louis Vierne. He was 2 years behind her in the conservatoire, so they were contemporaries. And Vierne said of Boulay, like something like, may we all be as good as her. You know, it was really a goal of his to follow in her footsteps. So. Yeah, I hope you enjoy. It's Andante, Prelude and Fugue next, and then Saint-Saëns. We're again traveling a little bit back in time for a very, very cheerful, very cute Prelude and Fugue. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you. So our organ builder's name is Jonathan Ortloff, and one of his building philosophies is to build an instrument that can be, that can go as quietly as to accompany a child's voice, and to grow as loud as to accompany the full congregation singing on Easter, right? Or Christmas. And these next two pieces, I think, really show off the breadth of this instrument. We're gonna get really soft and we're gonna get really loud. And I just wanna say a little bit first about the elegy for the time of change. So this was, you can read about it in your program notes, but it was written after the composer Robert Harris heard a sermon by the presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church, Michael Curry. And the sermon that he heard and that Bishop Curry preached was right following the murder of George Floyd. And in this sermon, Bishop Curry wove throughout his sermon little snippets of "There is a balm in Gilead." And as soon as Harris was done listening to the sermon, he was like, "I have to write." And so this is the this is what came from that. And you're gonna hear little snippets of "There is a Balm of Gilead," just musical versions instead of the words. And one other thing with this one, it begins with a pedal solo. It's a little bit ominous. And throughout, it kind of changes colors and becomes more hopeful. And that was on purpose. That was a dream of Mr. Harris. You know, we're in a dark time in our country. He wrote this 2 years ago, and I think we could argue that we still feel the same turmoil that we were feeling 2 years ago. And so, I don't know, let's feel some hope through it.
Thank you.
I don't have any more songs for you. That almost killed me. But please join us for a reception outside, and thank you again so much for coming.